Okay, in this particular lecture we have to study basically the force between the two infinitely length of the wire in which the current is flowing in same direction. The magnitude of the current is also same. So we have to check here the basically magnetic force, nature of the magnetic force. And Ampere was the first person who studied this kind of nature. As a result of the magnitude of the current, he measured the nature of this magnetic force. So here what we are considering, two parallel wires PQ and this RS, in which I1 and I2 current are flowing. The distance in between these two wires is smaller. So in the last lecture we have seen that when a current carrying conductor is kept in a uniform magnetic field, so this current carrying conductor realizes a magnetic force, and that magnitude of the force is F is equal to ILB sin theta, where I is the current which is flowing into that particular conductor, L is the length, and B is the magnetic field where that wire is kept, and theta is the angle with the magnetic field of that particular current carrying conductor. If theta is 90 degrees, only then we have seen that that time magnetic force is maximum, and this particular situation the magnetic force will be ILB. So keeping that idea in our mind, we have to basically now to study this particular situation where we have kept two wires of infinite length, this PQ, in which as I said I1 current is flowing, and second wire is of this RS in which I2 current is flowing. So first of all, what we have to do, I know that as a result of this current, a magnetic field basically will develop around this wire, and in the presence of that magnetic field we have kept this second wire. So I1 current is flowing into this particular wire, and because of that this B1 is the magnetic field where this wire is kept at the distance R. So magnitude of this magnetic field we know is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 and R. It depends on the I1 and R, where mu naught is the permeability of the free space. Permeability basically provides the information that how much field basically is penetrating to that surface. So this is the ideal situation, and here we have kept these two wires are kept into the free space in a vacuum. Only then this derivation we are drawing. So B1 is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 R. This magnetic field is because of this current I1. So second wire, this RS, which is kept into this particular magnetic field, will realize a force, and that force can be defined in terms of ILB sin theta, where I is the current which is flowing into the second wire. So I have considered that I2, length of this particular wire which is we have specified L, and the magnetic field because of the first wire. So that is B1. So force on this particular wire because of the magnetic field which is produced because of the I1 current will be F21 is equal to I2 L B1. So if I put the value of B1 here, it becomes mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R into L, and this is F21. So I can write this in this particular way also. F21 upon L is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. So this is the result, F21 upon L, force per unit length on this infinite length of wire will be based on the current I1, I2, that current flowing in itself that particular wire, and the distance between these two wires. So force per unit length is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. So, and now the direction. This is the magnitude of the force which is exerted on this particular wire because of this I1 current. Now, the direction of this particular wire we can find out through the Fleming's left hand rule. I1 current is flowing upward direction, magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane, so the direction of the force will be towards the first wire. This is the magnetic field, this is the direction of current, so this will be the direction of force. So this is the direction of force. And now the second case, after calculating the magnitude and the direction of this magnetic Lorentz force on the second wire because of the first, similarly one can find out for the first one. Now suppose I2 current is flowing into the second wire, and as a result the magnetic field will produce, and the direction of that magnetic force will be this one. Dot basically indicate, if I consider this is a arrow and this one is the tail and this is the tip, so tip of the arrow is represented by this dot and the tail by the force. So here in this particular direction B1, the direction is inward because of this, that the I use this right hand rule. The direction of the magnetic field will explain through the push of this palm. The thumb direction represents to the direction of the current, fingertips toward that point where we will have to find out the magnetic field. So the direction of push will be the direction of the magnetic field. Or on the other way, we can use the Fleming right hand rule, right hand thumb rule, and according to this the magnetic field will be inward, right, like this one. This is the direction of the current carrying conductor in which I current is flowing upward direction. Using the right hand thumb rule, the curl of the finger basically represent to the direction of the magnetic field. So right now the magnetic field is inward of this wire. If I use this wire and the direction of the magnetic field will be in the left hand side, that will be upward. If this is the wire, this is the wire, and because of that the direction of the magnetic field into this side will be like this one, tip of the arrow. So I have mentioned this dot because of that reason. So the magnetic field because of this wire towards this direction will be outward. So now this current carrying conductor, first current carrying conductor, is kept into this that particular uniform magnetic field at the distance r. So I have to find out the magnetic force, magnetic Lorentz force on this current carrying conductor, as I find out in earlier case on that second current carrying conductor. So again the formula will be same and the magnitude of the force will be same, but the direction of the force will be towards the second wire. So this is F12. While Now, right in this situation, the magnetic field direction is outward from the board, and that is this one. So, this is the particular situation. This is the direction of magnetic field. This is the direction of current, and this is the direction of force. That's why the force on that this particular current carrying conductor will be towards the second wire. So F12 is equal to I, that current which is flowing into the first current carrying conductor I1, length of the wire and magnetic field produced due to the second wire. So now B2 will be here, B2 will be equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I2 upon R. So if I put the value of B2 here, it becomes mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R into L, and again same F12 upon L is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. So this second result again same. So magnitude of the force because of this second wire on this particular on the first one is same as we have found in earlier case. So magnitude is same, but the direction of the force is opposite. Now the conclusion is F1 F2 is equal to F21, that is equal to F, is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. So force between the two wires of infinite length is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1, magnitude of the current in first wire, magnitude of the current in second wire, and the distance between these two wires. So F upon L, force per unit length on the wire current carrying conductor, is equal to this mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R. If L is equal to 1 meter, force per unit length, unit of this will be Newton per meter. This is the case when the current I1 and I2 are flowing into the same direction. But if suppose I change the direction into the RS current carrying conductors to the downward, then what will happen? Right now, the force between these two wires, magnetic force between these two wires are attracting. If in this particular situation when I am changing the direction of the current, then what will happen? So right now into this particular situation, the current is downward and magnitude is same. Distance between these two wires again same. So now in this case, I1 is flowing upward, I2 downward. So what type of nature of the magnetic field will be? Now I1, because of this I1, this I2 is kept in that particular magnetic field which is produced through this I1, and that is B1. So B1 is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 upon R. But right now situation is different, and according to the Fleming's left hand rule, the direction of force will be outward. So magnetic field is inward. Inside to the plane, because of the right hand thumb's rule, I am checking the effect of this first wire here. So magnetic field is inward and the current is flowing to the downward direction. So according to the Fleming's left hand rule, the direction of the force will be, so this is the situation. Here, this is the direction of current, direction of the force and direction of the magnetic field. So at this particular point, the force will be outward. And now, the magnitude of this force will be same as we have found earlier, that is F is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R into L. And similarly for this second wire, because of this second wire, the magnetic field will be produced around it and the direction of that will be inward. And again the situation is different because the, right now the current is flowing downward and using this right hand thumb rule, I found that magnetic field is basically penetrating to this whiteboard and in the direction is inward. So the symbol for that will be this cross. It means magnetic field is inward. Magnetic field is inward and the direction of the current is upward. So the resultant force on this current carrying conductor because of the second one will be again defined through this Fleming's left hand rule, where the magnetic field is inward, this is the direction of current and this will be direction of the force. So in this particular case, when the direction of current we have changed and the, you can say anti-parallel, so in this particular situation the forces becomes repulsive in between those two wires. In the first case we have seen that when current is flowing into the same direction, the magnetic force between them will be attractive, but when we are changing the direction of the current carrying conductor into that, what we are observing, that force are becomes repulsive into that particular, for that particular situation. So there are repulsive force. So there are two different situations when we use current into the same direction and current into the opposite direction. So from this result one can conclude definition of the ampere. So if F upon L is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I1 I2 upon R, where I1 and I2 is equal to 1 ampere and R is equal to 1 meter, the force exerted between them will be of the order of 2 into 10 raised power minus 7 Newton per meter. What does it mean? It means if 1 ampere of the current is flowing, magnitude of the current is 1 ampere, if 1 ampere current is flowing, whether that is situation is parallel or anti-parallel does not matter, then the force between them will be of the order of 2 into 10 raised power minus 7 Newton per meter. So here you can see that 1 ampere is that current which is passed in each of two parallel conductors of infinite length and placed 1 meter apart in vacuum cases each conductor to experience a force of 2 into 10 raised power minus 7 Newton per meter of length of the conductor. So this is the two different situations. Into the first case we have seen only one wire where that wire was kept into a uniform magnetic field And now what we have done, we just keep these two wires parallelly at this particular distance, and current was there of the order of 1 ampere, or the magnitude may be different. As I mentioned here, I1 and I2 can be same or different. So from this basically we can find out the nature of the magnetic force. On the basis of magnitude of the current, one can find out the nature of the magnetic force.